también es un delay. Y venir con soporte. Y le la porque tenía visto desde clase que vaya de la using a name a pertenecer a programa officer and tienes un nivel de issues very appreciated Mr. Anand also in our team and they have been really supportive of goodness when they have given ideas put us in touch with the right people across the world and have never said no to anything I requested if I didn't request for to meet goodness school. That's a wonderful thing to have. We also have a partnership with EU Heritage Tour. It is a European Commission funded program where they are trying to make heritage tourism, especially World Heritage Tourism, more popular among young people. This has started in five countries, including Austria, Italy, Belgium, and Portugal. These are the two small announcements. There's also one more thing. UNESCO is going to start a new kind of holiday experience called the Active Holiday. Our Active Heritage Holiday, starting with a pilot in July this year. And I hope you will also participate quite a few times here, and I hope you will participate in that. You'll hear more about that soon, but it combines heritage tourism with learning. We started with 5 people from my close friends. Now there are close to 2,000 people from 50 countries. And that's a recent growth. I think we are also on track to launch a South Africa challenge as well as a challenge in Netherlands and also Germany. So hopefully we will launch all these countries challenges this year. Moving on, so let's start with a question. Rather going to start with a question. Can we have a projector on, please? Tech is what we really use, but sometimes it does so that is what we started with. This is the picture we started the Coinesco challenge. And we would like you to identify all these word edit sites. F5 to the screen, please. That's the picture. This is the picture with a registry, so it is not a normal picture. It's a picture from Humpy, the World Heritage Site. And the picture has icons of World Heritage Sites in India. And that is the question I asked, or the tweet asked, or we asked, how many have you been to? So now I ask you this question, how many can you identify even? And this is on our Facebook page right now. And I would like you to comment on the post and tell us which ones you can identify. And based on how many you identify, you win some goodies at the end of this event. We can track that. And we will be participating in more fun ways. Keep your mobiles on. So, with that, my session is over. I'm really thankful for the guests. We have this panel, especially from my here from Delhi on a long weekend, especially. He may look young, but he has a lot of credibility behind him. He's a master in arts, and he studied in Europe, in some of the richest places in Europe, Germany, Italy, and France, I believe. So, yes. So I got that right. So he's got the credibility. He's even designed courses for a university and heritage tourism, and he's a very appropriate guest for this evening. I'd like to invite him upon the days and
good evening to all, and congratulations to the winners, and to all the enthusiastic visitors who visited as many as possible World Heritage sites in India or abroad. I'll talk a little bit because we are already late. And I'm not how you build UNESCO jargons or your academic jargons. First of all, I congratulate Ajay Reddy and his team and Go UNESCO for such a wonderful initiative, because UNESCO has created this voluntary stack, but creating, encouraging youngsters to visit these sites, creating it in a fun way is really appreciable. And I appreciate all the travelers who took this pain in 1 year, visiting all the related sites if possible. Yeah, I would like to say something about the World Heritage. When you see World Heritage word, there is word heritage in it. Now, what is this heritage? Heritage is something we have inherited from our past generations, which we need to preserve and pass on to the new generations. It can be a personal heritage, it can be an urban heritage at city level, at regional level, at national level, and then we have World Heritage. Now, how this World Heritage came into existence? In 1970s, Aswan in Egypt was being built, and due to the backwater of Aswan Dam, the temples built by Ramses II were supposed to be known under the water, and Egypt government actually requested all international community, various nations, to give technical and financial assistance, and around $50 billion were invested in that project, and that those temples were saved and elevated and put at the higher level. And that's how people came to know that heritage does not belong to one community, not to one nation, not to one country, but there is a heritage which is called universal heritage, or which is a heritage of mankind, where everybody is responsible for safeguarding of that heritage or saving that heritage. And that's how this concept of World Heritage came into existence. In 1972, the World Heritage Convention came into existence. Till date, around 190 countries have ratified this World Heritage Convention, and you have 981 sites listed as World Heritage Sites. India, it's only 30 sites. There are countries who have 45 or around 50 sites in countries like Spain or Italy. So India has to do a lot of work to get more and more sites on World Heritage List and manage them very well. I would also like to say what this World Heritage Stack means. Once a country gets any site listed on World Heritage List, it immediately attracts international tourists. There was a survey, and it has been shown in that survey that the tourism increases by 23%. Site becomes World Heritage. So you can imagine what economic benefit this tag can give to that country, to that site, to the community residing around this World Heritage site. Of course, it is important that the World Heritage, or any type of heritage, does not remain. They should be living heritage sites where people are enjoying this heritage. They are getting economic returns out of it, because if the community is not getting involved in the World Heritage Site or any heritage site in the country, in that region, they are not interested in it, because then regulations on them. Every benefit out of it. The second part, the tourism. If you don't get tourists, of course, it is not going to benefit from tourism. And in India, if you see, there are, I said, 30 sites are there, 26 natural, sorry, 24 cultural sites and 6 natural sites are there. And if you see these sites, you can trace Indian history through these sites, from Bhimbetka to DHR, the Darjeeling Heritage Railway, or CST, Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus in Mumbai. They show you the long Indian cultural tradition. And to know this Indian cultural tradition, youngsters like you should visit these kind of sites. And unfortunately, I'm from Maharashtra, and I know many people don't know that CST, Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus in Mumbai is a World Heritage Site, and millions and millions of them, they travel from that terminus, but they don't know about it. And I'm really glad that Ajay Reddy started this kind of initiative through fun, through entertainment. People are encouraged to visit to know more about the heritage, world heritage, your own heritage. And I request all of you, I'm sure you must be doing that, but please read some interesting facts about that particular heritage site history, and you'll enjoy the site more and more. Thank you very much, and I give all the best to Goa UNESCO and all their future projects, and UNESCO Delhi will always be there for all your initiatives. Thank you.
Another activity. I want to ask a question, and nobody is supposed to answer right now. Okay, the answer to this will be posted on our Facebook page. I'll give you the link. So basically, in every row under one scene, we have an image pasted stuck under the scene. So I request all of you to just look under your seats, and please pass it on to the other people once you've seen it. This is a World Heritage Site. A picture of a famous World Heritage Site located in India. I'm going to give you some clues about it, but please let me know once most of you have seen it, and the others please pass it on. The volunteers can please help passing on the pictures if required. Okay, so I hope most of you see the picture. Now, this is also known as the Black Pagoda. This is built by King Narasimha Deva of Eastern Ganga Dynasty around 1250. Please do not answer anyone right now. Post the answer of this image if you know it on a Facebook page. Our Facebook page is facebook.com/GoUNESCO. Please post your answer with the name of the site and hashtag GoUNESCO so that we can track it. And whoever guesses it right will be awarded at the end of the event. So proceeding with this, I request Mrs. Anuradha Reddy to please come up here and say something. Sure. Thank you. Hello, all of you. And I'm really happy to be part of this because I was part of the last program that Ajay did go in UNESCO in the country. And I'm really happy actually, where is Bharati? Bharati won last year's competition. And I'm even more happy because we discovered that I guided her when she was doing her architecture, which was a student. And this is something that is a personal passion, travel and discovering our world. I just was thinking today, because Ajay sent me a mail saying he's put one picture of a UNESCO site on the web. And I said, I cannot do this because his whole website or blog or whatever will crash if I put everything I have seen on this. And it is a wonderful experience to actually go and visit the UNESCO site. My recent visits have been to Mexico, where everybody says crime, mafia, things like this. The management of the UNESCO site is something that we need to learn. We talked about activity, about travelers. But I looked at the pictures before we went to Mexico. I said, my goodness, I mean, our age and our condition, are we going to be able to do this? When we got there, we took off the heat is called Calakmul. It is in a bio. It's in a biosphere forest, the second largest in the world after the Amazon. Discover Calakmul, the pyramid, and you think, oh, I'm going to climb this. So you do the first one, and then discover that there's a second pyramid leading off to this. So this is really an amazing view, and I have to see that in Hyderabad, in this state, not had a single UNESCO. The country talked about the UNESCO sites in India, there are 30. But in this state, especially in where I come from, that is Hyderabad state, the previous Hyderabad state entity, we had the beautiful, beautiful monuments like Ajanta and Ellora, which today have UNESCO status, but they go back to the support and care and the conservation 100 years ago. Because right now in Hyderabad, we are celebrating 100 years of the archaeology department. It was started in 1914 in Hyderabad, and then April, our first director of archaeology came to Hyderabad. It was a person called Gulani Asani. I want to place in your memory, Hyderabad state was Islamic, the rulers were Islamic. But the first monuments they looked after were Ajanta and Ellora. This consists of Buddhist, Jain, and Hindu ones. Their kind of focus, their kind of analysis, their kind of documentation, all of these things are something that all of us need to learn because India has such tremendous heritage, which I have learned actually by visiting other areas. So by visiting Cambodia or going to Thailand or going to Japan or China, or to go to the European countries, South America, Machu Picchu, the Jesus statue of the hill, Argentina, all of these sites are wonderful, wonderful UNESCO sites, both natural and built. So it's a lesson for us that our organizations that are in charge of looking after that heritage need to get up and move with it. We have, in Hyderabad, we applied 2-3 times for Charminar, to Golconda, for and unfortunately, the governments, the political will that needs to protect failed us. We do not have this recognition. And let me tell you, we have world class, UNESCO class sites. So, if there's anybody here who has not been to the Puthahari Falls, anybody? Anybody put their hands up? Has not been to the Puthahari Falls? And has not been? My goodness. It's a good thing you're far away. It's a good thing you're not close enough for me to become something. Let me share with you that they have recently started a wonderful interpretation center just outside Puthahari Falls, and when you go in there, you're introduced immediately into the full culture and history of Puthahari, and it will take you into another sphere altogether. So you please go, and the others who have not been in the interpretation center, please go. Because it's fine. Because you see things in a different light. So with this is a deep introduction, you want me to say anything else? Yesterday we celebrated what is called the Intact Heritage Award. We have been giving this for the last 19 years, and it's a recognition of the heritage of our city. And I look forward to all of you who are living here, who are working here. I know people who say I'm from Calcutta, I'm not Hyderabad. But if you're living here and you're working here and you're earning here, you are Hyderabad. So there is a huge pressure on you. Protect your environment and protect your health. So, with this message, I won't say anymore, but from time to time, if I need, I'll ask for it. Thank you so much. This is another ready. Okay, so another activity, and fortunately, Uri will be given right away. You don't have to wait to the end of the event. So, this is a quiz. I'm going to ask 10 questions. Whoever answers first, win. Starting with, which continent has the largest number of World Heritage Sites? First one. Yeah. Yeah, that's correct. Very chocolate. Okay, the next question. Very easy. Which of the following is a World Heritage Site? Brahma Temple, Pushkar, Rajasthan, Jantar Mantar, Jaipur, Chandanath, Hyderabad. He raised an answer, I can see. Yeah, that's right. So, third question. Founded by the Romans and the Roman Spa, identify the city located in the southwest of England, which the only city to that enjoys the World Heritage status. Wow. If you raise your hand. Yeah, you can answer. Right, that's right. the city of Ann. Next question. The Mahabodhi Temple Complex at Bodhgaya is the World Heritage Site of which it is still in Japan. That's right. You got this one right. Which of the following World Heritage Sites in India are found in the state of Gujarat? I'm going to give you four options. Please speak.
We should not have one more thought.
Yeah, exactly.
They already said that.
So, the four options are Sun Temple at Modhera, Sun Temple at Panama, Champaner Pavagarh Archaeological Park, Historic City of Panama. Yes, the second last one, please. What is the answer? Oh, that's wrong. Right, that's correct. Champaner Pavagarh Archaeological Park. This is fairly easy, very easy actually. The caves of Ajanta, Ellora, and Elephanta are the world heritage sites of which Indian states. I don't know if anyone can come with. That's my answer. Which of the following churches in India is a World Heritage Site to be found in the state of Goa? Can I see one hand over there? In the red, yeah. The lady there. Yeah, that's right. The city of Goa. Which of the following Indian railway terminus is also known as World Heritage Site? Okay, this has been given as a language.
So I didn't know about that.
I would still, you know, give the benefit of just having a topic. So anyway, I'm not going to give the options. Someone please answer. Yes, the Golden Peach. Yes, that's right. The question is not enough to answer at all. This is the following World Heritage Sites in India are to be found in the state of Assam. Does anyone want me to give you options in your answer to this? You would have already got chocolate. The last answer was the animal. Yeah, that's right. The Rajya Gandhi National Park. Can you ask the last question? Yes, can you ask me second one? So you managed to take a chocolate now. Okay, so the last question. I'll request someone to please put the image on the screen. So please identify the following heritage site, the heritage, World Heritage Site on the screen. I can only raise your hand, yeah. Okay, this one is just not supposed to answer. Why is it always going to be everywhere? Anyway, thank you so much. That is the activity that we had for you. Before we start off with the prize distribution, we at UNESCO wanted you to understand why sponsorship is important or why we appreciate sponsorship. As you all know, this is not a paid challenge, the UNESCO challenge.
So if we get these sponsors, we are able to get these really, really amazing goodies for all the winners of the challenge. As far as today's winners are concerned, we are going to be bagging prizes worth 75,000 in total. So I know that's just amazing. So, I'm just to find prizes that they're going to be getting. The first is free Himalayan trek by India Hikes. India Hikes is India's largest trekking community. Ajay and Rahul on free Himalayan trek. And Nishant will be setting up off on our Himalayan trek. Second is Heritage Holiday Experience at Hampi by Urama Heritage. They're sponsoring all three winners a 2-day, 1-night stay at a luxury property in Hanegundi. The third prize are two vouchers worth up to 5,000 rupees by Explore Hampi. Explore Hampi is an experiential tour operator at Hampi World Heritage Site. It's sponsoring Parul and Ajay for vouchers and Nishan for vouchers of up to rupees 5,000. The fourth prize and the fifth prize, travel accessories and very classy backpacks sponsored by Go Unis. Okay, so I put upon Parul and Ajay on the stage. Prize distribution center. The winners for the winners for challenge. I would request Mr. Arnold and Mrs. Angava to please present the winners with their certificates. I would also request Dr. Reddy and Mr. Ramakrishna Rao to please present the winners with their travel vouchers, accessories, backpacks. I now request the runner up for Nishant for the Golden Escape Finale 2015. I get request Mr. Anandan and Mr. Anandan to please present Nishant with the certificate. Author of French, Dr. Reddy and Mr. Ramakrishna Rao, to please present the chance to the backpack, travel vouchers, and the other accessories.
Okay, I'm my juniors from college. I did not know that earlier, but they're all from Nehru Jaipur. It was really lovely to find that out later during the day, you know, when they started laughing. And like, oh, they're all from my same college. I didn't know that. They're 5 years junior, 4 years, 5 years junior to me.
Oh, wonderful.
So I guess they might be juniors.
I am now Ajay's professor. Okay. So we also have a few mementos for the guests today. Ajay, I request you to please present these to the guests. Thank you so much, all of you. I now request the guests to please move downstairs. As you know, in 2013, UNESCO also went global, and it would be unfair not to mention the three leaders of the Global UNESCO Challenge. One is Gary, he's on a cruise right now off the coast of South Africa. And Sophie is in Bulgaria holidaying. And the third client was also traveling, enjoying. I just wanted to make mention of these people who were the three leaders of the UNESCO Challenge 2013, global leaders. Okay, so now let's do something fun with the winners of the UNESCO Challenge. So I request Atin Bhatt to please come on the stage. Generally, we talk more, we let you speak more. We just generally wanted to know certain things. So, how long have you guys been traveling, you know, even before UNESCO?
See, it was a
training
cruise.
Yeah.
And
it
was
a
training
How did you guys get to know about going to this? Because you've not been traveling, right? It's only the last 1 year that you guys have.
There's a lot of things happening. First, we went on to find
telephone work for solo. That is the okay thing to happen. And one thing I can simply not forget is when we went to the I need to say that Indian government needs to look into provisional toilets.
So there's this particular question that this for Parul. We asked Parul about her travel fantasy, and she says that you know she wanted to land in a country without the visa. But we know that's illegal, and we absolutely do not promote it. What is the motivation behind it? And there is a certain video that you also want to
watch. Okay, I thought you were laughing.
Let's do that.
Before we start, so we understand. So, this video is about, there is a series of photographs that I have taken during my time. Some of these are giving like level 2 while it is right and some are before that. And as a hobby, like photography is what I pursue. And then this travel thing is a subset of photography, I would say that I viewed it. So when you travel, you get to see new places and get to see new things to take place. So each of these photographs in itself tells a story. It tells a story about a person or a place whom where I've gone or I've met them. And if we see as a series of images, you know, there's a certain theme which is going and I'll maybe discuss. So, and most of the people that I've own photographs, I've put it. Life in general is about the people which are around us, but we kind of tend to forget them, or in our daily life, we miss these kind of people or some of these people that I want to show. So we can. Thank you.
So yeah, please, you can find someone who offers that. So, now Ajay is going to take the mic from me for 2 to 3 minutes. And knowing Ajay, we know that he's going to wrap it in 2 to 3 minutes. So Ajay, please come over and acknowledge all those guilty in making this event what it is.
Thank you so much. So we've seen a combination of heritage enthusiasts and travel enthusiasts already. I would like to talk about a small program we started this year. I did not expect much out of it, but it went pretty well. It is called the Goa School Campus Ambassador Program, and there are close to 80 plus students, undergrad and graduates from 15 countries already, who are going to lead for heritage clubs across the world. And that has just started. Even EU Heritage Tour, they were really, really impressed with that program. And I would like to show one small video which one of the campus ambassadors from IIM Ranchi created for GoINESCO. Just an introductory video for GoINESCO. Once the project gets on there. But the idea basically was to get, I mean, like I have mentioned earlier, GoINESCO objective is to make heritage and culture more accessible, interesting, and fun to young and hard people. And I believe that reaching out to students is a very important step in that direction. And that we have started. We haven't started any heritage clubs yet, but we hope to get there very soon. And the video up. This is a small introductory video which one of the campus ambassadors, Prashant Singh from IIM Ranchi, he created this. We don't have audio, but it says about GoINESCO and about in less than a minute. It is a very short elevation, which, so to say, it explains what GoINESCO is very simply, very clearly to us. Well-made animated video. It says to travel. That's the idea. It explains everything about the points, about how you get pointed, about how you win the challenges as well. Yeah. We'll take a bus, a plane, or just fly away on your next adventure with GoINESCO. All of you will travel a little bit more, but I would that was the video. There's also a lot of posters made by these kids, and I call them kids, but they're not. Well, I'm not that old, I think. Anyway, so there's a lot of interesting things that these guys did, and they continue to do. A lot of them are online right now, although we don't see a lot of people here, but they are online watching these proceedings. There's a lot of viewers from abroad as well. We are also doing a lot of workshops for all these students so that it is not just heritage-related workshops, but also something that will be useful for them in their careers in the future. I mentioned this specifically because otherwise there's a lot of clubs anyway going on. There's a lot of programs which I'll get them to work for a company or for a cause, but does it really help them in their careers later on? I'm not sure. Yes, maybe not. But the GoINESCO Campus Ambassador Program definitely does help them. Then coming to the short, hopefully, word of thanks. There's a long list of people. Please forgive me if I do miss somebody. I would like to thank Mr. Anand Kanatkar for joining us here all the way from Delhi. Dr. Lady Ma'am, who's been a constant support Dr. T. Nagendra Reddy, who has again graced us at this occasion this year. Hopefully you will come back, sir, again. Mr. Ramakrishna Rao, who is come back again. I hope he does like us here, that he does come every time. I really thank him. He's been on a very busy schedule and he still did come here. Thank you, sir, so much. Thank you, all of you. You came here on a Saturday evening. My family, some of my family members are here. The sponsors, Arjun Majumdar and Chandrasekhar Iyer from IndiaAnalytics, Mr. Arjun Bhatt and Dr. Basava from Explore Hampi, Ms. Shama Bawa from Urama Heritage Homes, Adra Dutta and Moish Shiva from the Culture Unit at University School New Delhi, Mr. Vaibhav Chauhan of sahapedia.org, Ashwini Singh, Mr. Rajesh Pichar, who is not here yet, but he's been a constant support, Mr. Vishy Chabral, and Anirudh Pandya, and the runners. My friends without whom this evening would not have been possible. I don't think it reached me if I miss anybody's name. Vishishuna, Anand Vedam, Yuta Jain, Shweta Dhanapani, Anil Kupa, Praveen, Bharat Kumaran, Ramya Adamki, Sarita Arya, Satya Kiran, Prashant Sukla, Yulia, Alexandra, Pani and Shiva from As and When, Pramod and team from KMK. There's quite a few who have helped in getting this event up today. You may not see them all up on stage, but trust me, they are here. And of course, all the Govindas to participants. If I may have all of you on the stage once for a group picture, we love you. All the winners this year, we also have a couple of winners from last year, Sriram and Jayarathi. They won last year. Please come on stage. Let's have a small group picture for posterity. Please. So, guests of honor, please, if you could join us for a group picture with the winners.
Okay, so all of you, we're not done yet with the activities, so we want to proceed outside and for the refreshment. So we have a blank India map over there on the flex, and we have all the World Heritage sites listed there. So you can just see that map, and you can go stick your, we give you 6 tips. You can go stick your name to whichever World Heritage sites you've been to. So I'm sure that will be fun, and we'll see how many chocolates we can give you for that. As all good things come to an end, the hope still lives. So all of you beautiful people, hope you enjoyed today's evening. And with the promise of bigger things in the fourth and subsequent UNESCO finales, we will take your leave. Do please share and oblige by our presence here. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much. I request everyone to please go outside for the impression.
Thank you, sir.